Welcome to Yogic Lady. So we're going to start lying down in the session today. If you come to lying down on your back, come into a comfortable supine position. Just let your feet fall out to the sides of the mat, let the palms face up to the sky, let the back of your neck be nice and long. Take a breath in through your nose, and then exhale through the mouth, and feel the weight of your body surrendering to the earth. And then bring your awareness to your breath, breathing in through the nose and out through the nose, and bringing the breath deep into the lower belly. So as you breathe in, you feel your belly swelling and expanding, and as you breathe out, there's a sense of release and of letting go. On your next inhalation, bring your knees in towards your chest. And then bring your hands onto your knees and just start to circle your knees around the hips. If you have one toe over the other, one big toe over the other, and then circle the knees around the hips, massaging the lower back and lubricating the hip joints. And then bring your knees together and extend the arms and the legs up towards the ceiling. Stack up the bones and the joints here, and then circle through the ankles and circle through the wrists, cycling one way and then the other way. And then just shaking out your arms and shaking out your legs, bringing the feet flat down onto the ground. Let's lift up the right leg, bring the hands to the back of the thigh, and then start to draw that right leg in towards the body. So you're flexing the toes in towards the shin, and you're drawing the leg in. You might like to slide your left leg away now, as you draw the right leg in towards you. Stay with the breath, calm and steady, rhythmic flow of breath. Good. And then bend up your left leg, come onto the sole of the foot again. And take the right ankle over the left thigh, draw the right knee away. You can either stay with this version, or you can lift up your left leg, catch hold of the back of the left thigh, draw that left knee in towards you. So you're drawing the left knee in and the right knee away, and you're staying broad across the lower back, the sacrum, back of the neck, nice and long. Soften the jaw, the tongue, the throat. Good. And then come down onto the sole of your left foot and slide your right thigh over your left thigh. Take both arms out to the sides, and then drop both legs over to the left. Soften the right shoulder down to the ground, and then turn to look out over the right hand. Good. And then inhale back through to centre and place the right foot flat down onto the ground. Lift up the left leg, catch hold of the back of the left thigh, extend the left leg up, and then just start to walk your hands up the back of the leg and flex the toes in towards the shin. And then maybe slide your right leg away if that feels comfortable. Try and keep the pelvis level on the ground and the shoulders relaxing down. Bring your awareness to your breath. And if there's any areas of sensation or intensity, just direct your breath into those places in order to release and soften. And then bend up the right leg, foot flat down on the ground. Take left ankle over right thigh, and then either stay here, bring the left knee away, or lift up the right leg, catch hold of the back of the right thigh, and draw the right knee in towards you. Right knee in, left knee away. Lower back pressing down. Good, and then come onto the sole of your right foot, slide left thigh over right thigh, take both arms wide, out to the sides, and then drop both knees over to the right and turn to look out over the left arm. So really let the left shoulder drop down towards the ground. Stay with the breath. And then inhale back through to centre. And then from here, if you undo your legs, and make your way up to a comfortable seated position. So either you can rock along your spine, come up like that, or you can one side and use your hands to help you come up. And then come to sitting in Sukhasana, sit comfortably. If your hips are quite tight, then you might want to sit onto a cushion. Otherwise, just sit straight down onto your sit bones and lengthen up to the crown of the head. Let's lift the shoulders up to the ears, roll them back and down. And then bring the hands together, joining up the right and left hand side of the body and the brain. Breathing into your heart space and breathing out. And then breathing into the space around the heart and the back of the heart. And breathing out completely. Inhale, the arms reach up. As you exhale, take the elbows wide, spread fingers, glide shoulder blades down the back. And then bring the hands back together, breathing in, reaching up. Breathing out, reaching wide and down. Hands come together, breathing in. And then breathing out. And then just bring your right hand onto your left knee and your left hand behind you. Inhale as you lengthen up through the spine and then exhale as you spiral over to the left. So really feeling into the upper back, that space at the back of the heart, the thoracic spine. Inhaling, lengthening, exhaling to twist. And then coming back through to centre, bringing the left hand onto the right knee, the right hand's behind you. Inhale as you lengthen, exhale as you turn. So you're moving in time with your breath, inhaling, lengthening upwards, and then exhale as you spiral over to the right. Okay, then they come back through to centre and bring your hands onto the ground. Just start to walk your fingertips forward. So you might be on your fingertips and be here, that's fine. Or maybe your hands reach a little bit further forward. Maybe you're coming onto your elbows, or maybe the hands reach all the way forward and the forehead drops down towards the ground. Good, and then walk the hands gently in towards you. And then from here we're going to transition onto all fours. So make your way onto your hands and your knees. Spread the fingers nice and wide. Have the knees under the hips and the heels of the hands under the shoulders. Okay, let's circle the shoulders around the wrists, hips around the knees, just to warm up the joints. Circling one way and then the other way. And then coming back through to centre, breathing in, lifting your heart and lifting your tailbone to create a kind of U shape in your spine. And then as you exhale, draw the navel back, drop the chin to the chest, and then draw the navel towards the spine, arching back. Inhale as you extend the spine, looking forwards and up. Exhale as you arch back. So you're moving in time with your breath, and the breath guides the movement. So the breath is moving like a wave up and down the spine. Okay, then they're coming back through to centre, and sliding the right leg back, come to the ball of your right foot and reach into the heel. Identify your left arm, reach the left arm forward, and then raise the right leg. So there's a line of energy from left hand to right heel, and you're reaching and lengthening. And then bring the left hands down, right knee down, slide your left leg back, come onto the ball of the foot, reach into the heel, reach right arm forward, and then raise the back leg. And feel that line of energy from right hands to left heel. Okay, then bring the right hands down, left knee down. Let's take the knees wide, bring the big toes together. Sink your bum back onto your heels, and then reach the arms forward, and you can come right up onto your fingertips, or if you have yoga blocks, you can bring your hands onto them like that. Have the elbows lifted, and then rest the forehead to the ground, and lengthen through the spine. And see if you can feel the movement of your breath in the back body. So you're breathing into that space at the back of the heart. Breathing all the way down into the sacrum and breathing into the spaces between the vertebrae. here, and then from here, you're using blocks, you can just move them to one side. Have a look at your hands. Have your hands slightly wider than your shoulders. Spread out the webs between your fingers, and then come up onto your knees and tuck your toes, and then lift up your hips. And keep your knees bent to start with. Come right under the balls of your feet, drawing the chest in towards the thighs, and then just start to bend one leg as you straighten the other. So you're walking out your dog here, you're in a down dog pose. Let go of your head, you're looking towards the back of the mat or between the knees. And then maybe you can start to straighten up the legs, but only do that if it feels comfortable, otherwise just keep a bend in the knees. And then you're drawing down into the heels, and lifting the sit bones high. Good. And then from here, let's raise up the right leg, reach into the heel, and then bring the right knee in towards the chest, look between your hands and step the right foot forward, come onto the left knee. Sweep the arms up, thumbs back, palms in. Let's take the arms wide out to the sides, and then bring the left arm over the right arm, bring the hands onto the shoulders, give yourself a little hug, and then bring the backs of the hands or the palms together. Lift the elbows and really ground down through your left shin. Make sure your right knee is exactly over the right heel. And you can kind of pull your right heel in towards the left knee. Okay, and then release the hands and bring the hands down. Frame your right foot, tuck back toes, and then roll up the right leg, reaching into the heel. Bring the right foot flat down onto the ground. Raise up the left leg. And then bring the left knee to the chest and step the left foot forward to come onto the right knee. Arms sweep up, thumbs back, palms in. Take the arms wide. And then bring the right arm over the left arm, hands on the shoulders. Backs of the hands together or palms together. Lift the elbows, soften the shoulders down. See if you can direct your breath into the space at the back of the heart. And then release the hands and the arms and bring them down, flat down to the ground, tap the back toes and lift up the left leg. And then place the left foot down. Have your feet about hip width apart, outer edges of the feet are parallel. And then walk your hands in towards your feet. Drop the heels down. You might bend your knees a little bit, so if you've got any lower back issues or anything like that, just bend your knees. Or if your hamstrings are really tight, bend your knees a little bit. And then let the weight of your body cascade down over the legs. If you catch hold of your elbows, bring the thumbs to the inner crease of the elbows. And you can start to straighten up the legs if you like, straightening one and then the other. Maybe straightening both, only if it feels comfortable. Good, and then let go of the elbows. Press down into your feet. And then inhale, slowly coming up to standing, stacking one vertebrae onto another, coming all the way up until you arrive on your feet in Tadasana, the mountain pose. And then let's reach the arms up, catch hold of the left wrist with the right hand, draw that left arm up and then over to the right and press down into your left heel. Okay, and then inhale back through to center, catch hold of the right wrist or the right arm up. And then over to the left. Inhale back through to center. Bring the hands to the heart and come to the front of your mat for Surya Namaskar. So have your feet about hip width apart. Bring the hands together in the gesture of love and gratitude. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Inhale, nose. And then exhale nose, but feel the breath in the back of the throat. Inhaling nose. Exhaling nose. So you can hear the sound of your own breath. It sounds a little bit like the waves on the ocean in the distance. Inhaling nose. Exhaling nose. your hands to the ground, step the right foot back, drop down onto your right knee, and then sweep the arms up, thumbs back, palms in. Exhale, pull it down, framing left foot, tuck back toes, and then lift up your hips, coming into down dog. Good, let's come down to the knees, and then drop the chest to the ground. Slide your arms forward, bring the elbows under the shoulders, forearms parallel, and then just turn your knees in a little bit. Press down into all 10 of your toenails, and then lengthen from the tips of your toes all the way up to the crown of the head, lifting the heart through the gateway of the arms, hugging shoulder blades into the upper back, and lengthening, opening the front side of the body. So either you can stay here, or you can turn your fingertips out, press into your hands, and then lift the elbows and come up a little bit more, but keep the shoulders moving down away from the ears. Keep bringing your awareness back to the breath, the Ujjayi breath, feeling breath in the back of the throat. Breathing in, and then breathing out, going all the way down to the ground. Bring the hands under the shoulders, tuck the toes, lift up the hips, stepping back into down dog, and then stepping right foot forward, coming onto the left knee, and sweeping the arms up, thumbs back, palms in. Bring the hands down, frame your right foot, step left foot forward, fold in, press down into the feet, sweep the arms up, lifting your heart towards the sky, and then bring the hands back to the heart. And if you close your eyes, scan through your body, just take a moment here, noticing sensation in your body, noticing your heartbeat, your breath, anything else that arises. Inhale the arms up, and then exhale, pour it down. Step your left foot back, come onto your left knee, sweep the arms up. Let's take the arms wide, bring the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers, inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, draw the knuckles down. You're really opening up across the chest area and squeezing the shoulder blades in towards each other. And then release the hands, bring them down, frame your right foot, tuck the back toes, lift the hips higher, step back into down dog, and then drop down to knees and lower the whole body all the way down to the ground. So this time we're going to bring the hands under the shoulders so that fingertips line up with the tops of the shoulders. Hug the elbows to the sides of the body and then have a sense of putting your heart forward and up using your back muscles, and then exhale down. Then take the hands out to the sides, come onto the fingertips, inhaling up on the fingertips, and exhaling down like a wave. Bring the hands under the shoulders, tuck the toes, spread the fingers nice and wide, lift up your hips, making your way back into down dog. And then step left foot forward, come onto the right knee, sweep the arms up. Take the arms wide, bring the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers. See if you can do up your fingers the unusual way. Lift the chest, draw the knuckles down. And then release the hands. Take them to frame your left foot, step right foot forward, folding in, press down into the feet, arms sweep up, slightly arch back, and then bring the hands back to the heart. And again, just take a moment here, noticing sensation, breath, heartbeat. Good, and then release the hands. And let's step back the left foot. So the right foot's forward. Line up your right heel with your left instep. And then open up through your arms. lift up, spread the toes. And when you do that, feel the area above the knees lifting. And then place your toes down, turn the right palm up, reach up and bring the left hands down on the back of the left leg. Come back through to centre and then lengthen both sides of your torso and drop the right hand onto the right leg. So the hand just lands anywhere on the leg and you're reaching up the left arm, spiraling the chest up, turning to look up to your hand, to your thumb, or you can be looking down towards your right big toe. And then reach into that top arm to come up. Swivel on your feet and turn your left toes to face out. Open up through the arms. Turn left palm up, reach up, bring the right hand down the back of the right leg. Then come back through to centre, reach and lengthen and drop the left hand onto the left leg and reach up with the right arm. Turn the chest, turn to look up. Inhale, coming up, release the arms. Now we're going to turn the feet so that the outer edges are parallel, slightly pigeon-toed here, and then bring the hands onto the waist. Inhale, lift the chest, lengthen the spine upwards, and then as you exhale, hinge at the hips, lead with the heart, and fold forward. And then just drop your hands onto the ground under the shoulders. Inhale, look forward, lengthen the spine, exhale. Walk your hands forwards, but keep your heels pressing down and then let go of your head. Coming into a lovely forward fold. Okay, and then walking the hands in towards you. Bring the hands under the shoulders. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, fold in. And then walk the hands back so that fingertips line up the toes. Forearms are parallel and then the crown of the head moves down towards the ground. You're pressing into the mound of the big toe, the little toe, the outer edges of the feet and the backs of the heels. And you're lifting the arches of the feet. Good. From here, let's just walk the hands forward, bring the hands under the shoulders. And then walk the hands over to the right. Bring your left hand somewhere onto your right leg and then reach up with the right arm, turning the chest. Good. And then bring the right hand over to the left leg and reach up with the left arm. And then bring that left hand down. Bring the hands to the waist, press down into your feet and inhale all the way up. And then heel toe your feet in. So now we're going to take a balance. So if you drop the weight into your left foot and bring your hands to your waist and then pick up your right knee, take it wide out to the side, down, do that again. And then bring the sole of your foot into position for tree pose. Bring the hands together and then reach the arms up. Sway around if you like. Circle through the wrists. And then bring the hands back together and to the heart. Let's bend the left knee, take the right ankle over, and then start to fold forward. Fix your gaze to a spot on the floor. And then maybe drop your fingertips down. So drawing the right knee towards the ground. Good. And then bring the hands together and inhale, coming up. Lift up the right knee, palms face up, deep breath in. Exhale, lower down. Other side, so we're going to lift up the left knee. Take it wide out to the side and down. Do that a few times and then bring the sole of the foot into position. Bring the hands to the heart, reach the arms up. Take the knee as wide as you can. You might take the arms out to the sides. You might sway around a little bit if you want to test your balance. And then bring the hands back together to the heart. Start to bend your right knee. Take left ankle over right thigh, folding in. Maybe dropping fingertips to the bringing the hands back together, inhaling, coming up, pick up the left knee, point the toes, palms face up, exhale, slowly down. Good, let's take the feet a little bit wider, toes out, heels in, bring the hands together, inhale the arms up, and then exhale down into squat. So you're taking your arms inside your knees, and then pressing your knees into your arms, and drawing the thumbs in towards the breastbone. Good, and then bring the hands behind you, sit down, bring the soles of the feet together, take the hands around the feet, lengthen the inner thighs, lengthen the spine, all the way up to the crown of the head. And then from here, either you can stay here, or you can fold it forward, and bring your elbows onto your thighs or your calf muscles, and then fold in. Again, just exploring your edge, and allowing the breath to take you deeper into the pose. So it's gravity combined with breath that takes you there. Good, and then inhale, coming up. Good, bring the hands onto the knees. And then bring the hands to the backs of the thighs and lift up your legs. And reach the arms forward. And then extend the legs. So you're lifting from the back of the heart, squeezing the thighs and drawing the navel back, looking towards your toes. So you can always have the knees bent. And then from here, we're going to bring the feet onto the ground and then lower down. Line up your heels with your sit bones. Take a breath in through your nose. And then as you breathe out, press down into your feet and lift up through the spine, vertebrae at a time. Bring the hands underneath you. Clasp your hands. Tuck your shoulders under your chest. Pull the knees away from the body. Keep lifting and lengthening. And then draw the chest towards the chin. Gently engaging your glutes to lift the pelvis and then release the hands. Slowly lower down to the ground. Good, and then bring your knees into your chest. Take your right hand to the outside of the left knee. Drop both knees over to the right. Soften the left shoulder down, turning to look out over the left hand. And then inhale back through to centre. And then take your left hand to the outside of the right knee. Drop both knees over to the left. Soften the right shoulder down. Turn to look out over the right hand. And then inhale back through to centre. Slide your legs away. And let your feet fall out to the sides of the mat. Let the palms face up to the sky. Let the back of your neck be nice and long. Your awareness to your breath. Feel the flow of your breath. Completely release and relax all the muscles in your feet, your heels, your ankles, calves, shins, fronts and backs of knees, fronts and backs of thighs. Soften your buttocks. Release the lower back, middle back, upper back. Let the shoulders roll downwards, outwards. Tops of the arms, elbows, forearms, wrists, hands, fingers, fingertips. Back of the neck, back of the head, crown of the head, forehead, eyes, cheeks, ears, nose, mouth, tongue, chin, jaw, throat, chest, navel,